guys, welcome to my channel and to St. Petersburg vlog. So I am right now in the Sapsen train, and this is basically a high speed train that takes you from Moscow to St. Petersburg in just 4 hours. We are about to reach St. Petersburg in just 5 minutes, and can you wildly guess what is the time outside right now? It's sunlight. And okay, I'll leave it to you, because there's something very special about St. Petersburg, especially during this time of the year. That's the second week of June. And yeah, stay tuned to find out what is so special about St. Petersburg in June. Right now the temperature outside is 18 degrees Celsius, and we are pretty much guessing that it'll be slightly colder than Moscow. So we are keeping our fingers crossed, because I think abhi jo mere paas kapde bache hue hain wo bhi sweatshirts, and they are basically warm clothes. So I really hope that it's not as hot as Moscow. I'm just loving the weather of St. Petersburg. Well, right now it's 10:45 in the night, and there's still light over here. It's not dark, and that's what's special about St. Petersburg, guys. White nights of St. Petersburg in the second week of June, and that really makes it even more special to visit during this time of the year. It's a little bit more expensive than the rest of the year, but yeah, I mean, this is something like a one-of-a-kind experience for us. So right now we just had a dinner, and we are going to check into the hotel, and then we have a lot on the itinerary tomorrow and day after. So yes, stay tuned. So guys, this is our first day of city tour of St. Petersburg, and right now we are going for a river cruise on the river Neva, which is the main river of St. Petersburg, and it is 74 kilometers long, and it's looking very beautiful. Done with the river cruise, and now we are proceeding for the city tour. And a little bit about the place. So this city is named after Peter the Great, and has 60 river canals and 40 islands. And right now we were on the river Neva, where we had our river cruise, and it was so beautiful. There was sun on our head, but it was still feeling so cold because of the cool breeze and winds. So yeah, that was a lovely cruise, and now we are heading for the city tour. So what I absolutely love about St. Petersburg is that there are so many river canals and so much of water to see when we are riding and when we are on our way. And anyone who knows me knows how much I love rivers and lakes and seas. So yeah, it just makes me feel so good about a place. So girls and boys, welcome to the main central square of St. Petersburg. And that one behind me is the Winter Palace, and this white and yellow building was made initially for the Russian army. So this place is the one where all the grand parades, activities and demonstrations in St. Petersburg take place. And now our tour guide is taking us to an Indian place for some lunch, and we are really hungry because the breakfast today wasn't so good. So yeah, we are very hungry, and we're going to an Indian place now. Papa is so ahead of us, always. So we just got done with the lunch, and our tour guide took us to this Indian restaurant, which was by the name Red Monk Cafe, and it serves Indian European cuisine, and we were so much taken by surprise that the food tasted so much similar to our Indian taste. Even nicer was that the waiters were, you know, wearing those Indian kurtas as their uniform, and there was also 80s and 90s Indian music playing in the background. So yeah, it just gave us proper Indian feels. So we are going to the Hermitage Museum now, and we have one more place to visit for today. That's the Saint Isaac Cathedral, and I think that's pretty much it for today, but we'll find out. So here we are at the Hermitage Museum, and behind me you can see there's a long queue of tourists who want to visit the museum, and it's a museum of arts with more than 3.5 million exhibits. So yeah guys, that's a lot, but we do not have so much of time, and our tour guide said that it can take lots of months to see all the exhibits. So yeah, we are gonna quickly finish visiting the museum, but for now we have to stand in that long queue. So we have our tickets for the Hermitage Museum, and we've been given these earplugs so that we can hear what our tour guide tells us and explains us about the artwork and paintings inside. Done visiting the Hermitage Museum. It was definitely very beautiful, and we are waiting for our bus. So after the cathedral we will go to the dinner place and then back to the hotel, but for now I'm gonna have one of those corns. Love the boiled corns over here, by the way. And yeah, you can see the river Neva again behind me. It's looking super beautiful, by the way. So we are at the Saint Isaac Cathedral now, and just for your information guys, up to 70% of people of Russia are Orthodox Christians, so that's their main religion, and that's why there are a lot of cathedrals in Russia. So we are inside the Isaac Cathedral, and this happens to be the fourth largest cathedral in the world. And yes, we've worn shawls and like stoles now because it started to get colder. So just have a look at all these beautiful carvings and paintings which is done inside the cathedrals and museums. It's really so mesmerizing to see. Oh, so we just happened to pass by this dancing street in St. Petersburg, where people just come very casually to dance freely with their partners. And yeah, I mean, this was something very nice and interesting to watch. So we finally arrived at our hotel now, and I thought of quickly showing you what our hotel in St. Petersburg looks like. By the way, we are staying in Park Inn by Radisson, and that's not the original name of this hotel. It was originally named as, wait for it, yep, that's the original name of the hotel. It's Pribaltiskaya, and its hotel was originally made for the Olympic players, and since the name was so difficult to pronounce, they renamed it as Park Inn. And now let me show you the amazing room of Park Inn where we are staying. guys, it's finally our last day in Russia and of course St. Petersburg. So today we are visiting two main places, no actually three places. The first that we are going right now would be the Peterhof. It's a palace, and then we will be going for the Lady Kazan Cathedral and later the Paul and Peter Fortress. Yeah, I think that's the sequence. But whatever, we'll find out. The Peterhof Palace now, and it took us almost 1 hour from the hotel to reach here, and it was so amazing that we were greeted with a national anthem, and now we are walking to the palace. It's a grand palace, and it was established after Peter the First. People, we are now inside the premises of Peterhof, and you can see that beautiful fountain behind of me, and right now we are standing in that queue to get inside the palace, and we've been given these earplugs again just like yesterday for the audio guide. So beautiful that was. Now we were inside the central part of the palace because it's a very huge palace with so many fountains all around it, and that actually enhances the entire beauty of this particular place. And this palace is basically dedicated to Peter the Great and all his relatives, so there were a lot of paintings and portraits of his family. And yeah, we went through, you know, the main dining room, the audience room, the officers on duty room, and their bedroom also, and it was like just so beautiful beyond words. I think this is one of the very much speciality of St. Petersburg, that the museums and cathedrals over here are so humongous, with beautiful carvings on the walls and sculptures and gold hues and white walls. So that actually makes it even more beautiful. I'm in love with the ice creams of Russia. Just, we are having like one ice cream every day. Right now I'm having this mango ice cream and it's so tasty. So right now we are outside the Peter and Paul Fortress, which you can see behind of me, and this was basically made after the death of Peter the Great, and he was buried inside this particular fortress. At the cathedral, this is the last stop of our city tour of St. Petersburg, and this cathedral is named after the Lady of Kazan, who helped the people of Russia during the time of fire and disaster. Thank you. as by now you must have already seen that the cathedrals and museums over here are all so damn pretty, with amazing architecture and such lovely chandeliers, and yeah, they just look so pretty to the naked eye. So we are back to the hotel now, and today was Russia Day. It's the 12th of June, and this is the day when the Russians got independence, and that was one of the reason why today it was so crowded everywhere, because it was public holidays, so all the people were out enjoying their holiday. Maybe it's 11 p.m. right now, and just for the last one more time, let me quickly show you the beautiful white nights of St. Petersburg. So we are seated in the bus and checked out of our hotel, and now we are proceeding to the airport for a flight back to Tashkent, which will take us back to Delhi. We are back to India, and guess who got fever on the flight? And oh my god, it was so cold inside. I was shivering throughout the flight, like three blankets were also not enough. And that brings me to you a tip, that whenever you are traveling in a plane, please carry some warm coat or blazer, sweatshirt, whatever, because bahut zyada sardi hoti hai, and I was really cringing, why didn't I carry one? But anyway, it's 4:30 in the morning right now, and my eyes are literally burning right now. I want to sleep, but I have one more flight to catch, that's to Ahmedabad, then mummy papa are going back to Ajmer, so this is where I see them, bye bye. And our trip finally comes to an end. Thank you so much, I hope you enjoyed the vlog. And if you did, you know what to do. Please like, comment and share the video. And please do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Subscribe now.